going, guys. I just wanted to do a quick tutorial on 5.7. If you haven't watched 5.6, I suggest that you go and watch that one, because we're going to just kind of run through this pretty quick. This is just to kind of help you set up the 5.7. 5.7 has a few changes, and it runs a couple games that don't run on 5.6. So we're going to go over that real quickly right now. Okay. All right. So if you come into config, you're going to notice that there are a few changes kind of off the bat. I think plugins and paths wasn't really there before. I think it was just like plugins. Now I believe that there's just like a video option configuration for you. It's a little bit different. I believe that's because of what I'm about to show you next. Okay, so if you go into plugins and paths, you're now going to notice that there is a new video plugin here, which is GPU DX11. All right, so that was one of the new plugins that came with 5.7, I believe. So from now on, if you want to get the game to run, I believe this is the recommended video plugin. Okay. Another notable change is the NetPlay plugin. This is going to be a little bit different from 5.6. I did not add a different Calera plugin this time. I just basically kept the same Calera plugin and used what they had available for this version. Okay, so you'll notice that, of course, I've already set up the plugin paths, already set up the ROM folder. I decided to go ahead and use the Demul 5.6 instead of using, you know, putting the ROMs in 5.7 and having to do that all over again. You know, this is just more simpler to do. Okay. The other thing that we're going to go ahead and go over are also the controls. They've now set it up a different way. As if in 5.6, you'll notice that there were three different controls that you had to do in order to set up a joystick, but now there's only two, and that, of course, is the Dreamcast console version, and then for setting up the arcade. So that will now set up the Atomos Wave and all the different arcade boards that are emulated on this emulator. Okay. And last but not least, now you can just look and see that you're able to run a few more ROMs. Here you have like some of the Model 3 ROMs that you're able to run. And then, of course, now you can run some different games that you weren't able to run on the Thomas and on Naomi boards also. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and just select a game that I have running on here, which is Hokuto no Ken. I found that I couldn't really run it on 5.6, so I went to 5.7 and I had a better outcome with that one. So that is something to think about. You know, if it's not working on one version, it may just work on another version. So this plugin is a little bit different from the other one. You're actually able to go on an actual server and basically see if you can find people to play with on a server, although you probably won't have as much success because there's not really that many people playing on here. So in order to look up servers, we just hit master server list here, and then you'll get a list of basically some servers that you can play on. Okay. And as you can see, you have the pink number here, which shows you which one is the better server, and you know, what's the best server to use with your ping. Okay. Right now, I guess I'll go with the Killer Instinct, which is in Dallas, Texas, although that is pretty much out of my way. You're probably going to want to go with one that is closer to you. But just for this example, I'm going to go to the one with the highest ping and see what happens. Okay. So there's not too many people in this room, so this actually might be a good place, but like I said, once again, with location, that's also important. As you can see, there is basically a rating room here with games. People are basically setting up to play a game. This works with different emulators. You don't have to have the exact same emulator in order to play on this server. So what I'm going to do is I would just come over here, and I'm basically going to create my own room. And then, of course, a player would come in here after I've created my room and join, and then we would just hit start. And then, of course, that starts the game up. So that's just the difference between having the regular P2P and the actual server based game setup. Okay. So if you come over here to this area here, there is still an option for P2P. So if you do want to go ahead and just connect the way that we did in the previous version, you can. And I do still suggest that you do so, because it is the better connection. Okay. So that's about it. Once again, of course, you want to make sure that the game is running at least at 60. You know, give or take. Some games, of course, might not be able to run at 60 properly, but that's basically what you want to target. You want to target a game that is running at 60 frames per second. Okay, so that's pretty much it. That's the end of the tutorial. Hopefully this helps you out. You know, have fun and enjoy. Take it easy.